history gets lost easily.
Jesse Erickson is talking about the photographs in this box donated by a University of Delaware alumna. They make up what is called the Baltimore Collection. Erickson is the coordinator of special collections and digital humanities at the university.
These photographs are tremendously important in challenging a narrative that was endemic during the late 19th century and early 20th century.
Erickson says it's a narrative rife with images like these perpetuated by Jim Crow.
Stereotypes which portrayed black folks as ignorant and uncultured and other sort of negative and harmful caricatures of the black community.
But these photos tell a completely different story. Erickson says they represent positive, empowering images of black people during this period. Erickson worked on the project with Professor Julie McGee, and students like Kelly Coles helped identify the origins of the pictures.
We looked at their backs or their covers to see if we could find an inscription that mentioned a Baltimore studio or a Baltimore address.
She and other students researched the studios. This picture was taken at the Egbert G. Fox Photography Studio on North Gay Street.
And I found that he was a Civil War photographer, it seems, and after the Civil War, he decided to move to Baltimore and open up a studio.
Cole says she relied on the fashion in the pictures to help identify the time period, and there were other clues.
Another student studied this photo, the clothing, the teddy bear, the ground underneath the subjects, to identify time and place.
She discovered in 1913 ready-mixed cement was first delivered in Baltimore. Armed with that knowledge and research of the clothing, she was able to narrow down the time period of the picture between 1915 and 1925. The collection has left lasting impressions on the students.
There were white photographers who were interested in helping black people photograph themselves, help them create these likenesses that they could share with their family and friends.
Erickson says this treasure trove of photographs also shows a generation out of slavery, African Americans doing well coming out of Reconstruction.
Not all of us were sort of mired in a lot of the challenges that we did face as a community, but through our education, through our civic engagement, and through our perseverance, we were able to achieve tremendous gains.
Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News.